What's up, everyone? John Rettinger from Techno Buffalo here with an unboxing of one of the hottest handsets on the market. This is the extremely powerful and capable Galaxy S2. We've already seen it dressed up in Sprint clothing. Let's go ahead and take a look at AT&T's variant. All right, so you're gonna be able to get your Android loving hands on this guy on October 2nd for just under $200. This is hot off the presses. It just came to us courtesy of the folks at Samsung. So we've got Galaxy S2 on the front, Samsung pictures, blah, 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 and some specs on the back. But of course, we're gonna talk about all this good stuff. 4G is the HSPA Plus variety. All right, let's go ahead and dig in. I'm really excited to take a look at this. The Galaxy S2 is arguably one of the most powerful, if not the most powerful phone on the market and capable phone on the market. Looks like this one's actually powered on dot system. All right, so here's the phone. Push it off to the side for just a quick minute and see what else we are going to get in the box. Anybody taking guesses? It's gonna have a cord and a charger. So we've got some books that probably not gonna read. The standard Samsung charger we've seen with most of their phones and a micro USB cord, blah, 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 accessories. Let's go ahead and take a look at the phone. It is worth noting though that in our FedEx package that this came in, there was a HDMI cable included in here. I'm not sure if it's going to be included in the box when this finally gets retailed, but you know, it was included in ours. All right, so we'll go ahead and peel off the stickers. Looks like it's doing something here. Go ahead and just hit home, reboot system now. What it do? It's something happened in the shipping. We'll go ahead and peel off the sticker there, and we'll go ahead and let it reboot. Samsung Galaxy S2, you can see the splash screen while I talk. Let's go ahead and move it over, zoom in. Let's run through the specs, because there's a lot to talk about on this guy. You've probably heard about this, I'm assuming, and probably know the specs by heart like I do. But let's go ahead and run through them anyway. You are looking at an absolutely gorgeous 4.3-inch, of course that's diagonal, Super AMOLED Plus display. So what does Super AMOLED Plus mean? Essentially what it boils down to is you're going to get darker darks, you're gonna get more vibrant colors. You're also gonna get better visibility in direct sunlight. You're gonna get a little bit of a bluish hue, but not nearly as bad as we've seen on previous AMOLED screens. This is probably one of the best screens on the market right now. One of those phones you really have to sort of see it to appreciate it. So we'll slide that off to the side here. Protecting this screen, which has a resolution of 480 by 800, is Corning Gorilla Glass. So if you put this guy in your pocket with some keys, not to worry, you're going to be okay. All we're looking at right now is TouchOS 4.0 sitting on top of Android Gingerbread. And powering this guy is a crazy fast dual core 1.2 gigahertz processor. And if you're like me, you probably want to see what the Quadrant score is going to be on this guy. So I'm going to run that probably the first thing I do when I do my test to see how fast this thing really is. It's got a gig of RAM to help it do its thing. 16 gigs of internal storage. On the back, we have an 8 megapixel camera with LED flash. I can also shoot 1080p video at 30 frames per second. And on the front, that is not a VGA camera. That is actually a 2 megapixel camera on the front for video chat or taking your Facebook photos of yourself or making sexy face. This thing is extremely thin and really light and weighs in at 116 grams. Let's go ahead and pull off the back. Let's see what size card is going to come with the phone. So SIM card included, looks like no micro SD card is in here, at least on our demo unit. But you'll have 16 gigs of storage here as well, and you can augment that with an extra 32 gigabyte card. Go ahead and slide this plastic back on, and we'll do a real quick tour of the device. That back was very thin, kind of flimsy. Alright, so let's take a quick look at what we got. Push that down on the table. So you got your screen, obviously, your four Android capacitive buttons. You got menu, home, back, and search. Camera and sensors on the upper left-hand corner. On the left, volume rocker up and down, pretty well pronounced. On the right-hand side, you've got a power and lock button. On the top, there's your 3.5 millimeter headset jack. On the bottom, your microphone and micro USB charging port. The phone is really incredibly light. One of those things you gotta hold in your hand to appreciate. Let's do a real quick size comparison here. Here is the iPhone 4, all gussied up in white. It's definitely a difference in the screen size. But look at this thinness. Especially when you consider this guy's rocking a 1.2 gigahertz dual core processor, gig of RAM, It's very impressive. Let's bring in my daily driver here. This is the BlackBerry Bold 9900. You can see all these guys on top of each other. We'll make our smartphone sandwich. And you can really appreciate the thinness of the Samsung Galaxy S2. If anything you guys want to see from this phone, be sure to let me know in the comments. I'll be doing hands-on a ton of other videos, but I wanted to show you at least a quick demonstration during the unboxing what the phone looked like and sort of a short overview of what it can do. See the keyboard right there as well. Should have swipe on there, but not enabled by default evidently. So we'll see what AT&T's got on here. We'll go ahead and jump into applications. Take a quick look at some of the AT&T business that's in here. Typical stuff, my AT&T Navigator, and it's smooth scrolling, so we can keep going from app page to app page without worrying. If you can keep up with me, you can see everything that's on there. So for all of your Samsung Galaxy S2 coverage, be sure to check out technobuffalo.com. And again, anything you want to see, leave it in the comments down below. I am John Rettinger from Techno Buffalo, and I'll see you in the next video.